Scope is still alive.
No, he's not. He's frozen. That means it's dropped.
No, he's still... I'm watching him.
Well, he's frozen for me, so I thought he dropped.
Maybe that's your internet.
Are live. Welcome
We're live.
To Done Deal.
Welcome to Done Deal. All right. How's it going, everybody? Put ones in the room if you can hear us.
There we go. Hey, welcome, everybody. All right, we're good.
All right. So, welcome to Done Deal. Welcome to Vapor Joke Live. Excuse me, I was eating before the broadcast. I was starving. I haven't eaten anything all day. Welcome to Done Deal, Vapor Joe's Live, where we give you the week's deals and steals, news, possible tidbits on new items coming out, vape mail, things of that nature. Answer some of your questions. Wow, somebody said, just a heads up, Vapor Beast is doing an authentic Aerotank Giants in clearance for just $14.99. Wow, that is a great deal. I'll be doing that. Thank you, TBC Armor, Amor. Let me just, could you put a link in the room for that for me, please? If you could, oh, I got slow mode on, I believe. Hold on, let's see if I can. There we go. I took slow mode off. If you could put that link in the room, that would be great.
Son of Sam, Tiger, if I vaped 0.5 ohms at 30 watts, would I need to change my juice mixture? No. Even the thickest VG juices, if handled properly, will generally wick well, provided your atomizer wicks well. I'm going the wrong way. I just realized I'm rereading the question going, wait a minute, that's not what he's asking. I'm answering a question you didn't ask. Let me answer the question you did ask. If you're going to go low, you might want to go higher VG. But I don't know what your mixture is right now. Would you need to change your milligrams? Depends what you're vaping now. If you're going from like an ego kind of setup to now dripping at 0.5, oh yeah, you're going to want to drop your nick. It's going to hit you like a freight train. For dripping, I typically drip 6 or lower, but in tanks, depending how efficient the tank is and how much it delivers, I'll go as high as 12. And it's always handy to have 18 around for those stressful moments you just need a harder hit.
Alright, let me do this here.
Bear with me, I'm just finishing my snack. My stomach was growling so loud after Mod Envy, I was afraid you guys would hear it, so.
Okay, oh yeah, I found it. So here we go. There's the link for, he put it in there too. That's a link to Vapor Beast's $14.97 giant tank. I'll be doing that after. That'll be my new deal after I get off. And don't, now, don't stop there. Use coupon code YEAHBABY, YEAHBABY. That will get you 10% off that total. So it'll come down to like $13.50.
Wow.
So use, look at the, that coupon code should work. Yeah, baby. It'll get you 10% off. So, yeah, it's a big tank. It's meant for 26,650.
Alrighty. Well, we have some news this week. And I'm just, sorry, message is just off the hook tonight. Joe, 46 million, go.
1 million more than 45 million. No, yeah, we hit that in record time. I think it was less than 8 days. We went from 45 to 46. Great showing, and we took the day off yesterday into today, and it was all kinds. Somebody talking about pregnant? Are you pregnant, Tiger?
Absolutely not.
Oh, Gay Vapor is pregnant. Oh, I'm sorry. Gay Vapor, are you pregnant? Well, anyway. So, yeah, we hit 46 million. We took a day off, a well-needed day off, I have to tell you. It's been fucking busy for the last few weeks, so. Fantastic.
DeAngelbury. Did I get it right that time? DeAngelbury? Dean. Oh, Dean Gulberry? Am I getting closer? I'm not sure where to go with that. There's too many ways for the letters to work together. In any case, Dean Gulberry. Okay. Oh, okay. I got it now. very cute. And yeah, I didn't even think about that. You guys are asking me if I'm pregnant, and then I'm drinking, and it's like, yeah, no, I didn't think about that. But absolutely, I am not. Absolutely not. I got myself something really, really strange when I was out yesterday. I went to pick up a bottle of wine, and they had at the till these Bah Humbugs. It's a beer, but it's got a cinnamon sort of overtone to it. And I was like, it's either going to be Christmassy and festive and not too bad, or it's going to really be gross. So that was my first sip. And jury's still out. I think it's interesting, though. I think it's interesting.
Yeah, when you hear cinnamon and beer, I have to get off camera for just 1 second, but I'll be on my mic. You know, when you hear cinnamon beer, I was never a really big beer drinker. I was always a big wine or alcohol drinker. You can't really, I don't know, cinnamon and beer just seems to go funny. But does it taste like holidays, or does it taste
does.
Like...
It kind of does. It's like a festive beer. It kind of makes me want to hear jingle bells and stuff.
Okay.
It's interesting. I don't think I would buy this again, but I won't have any trouble finishing it.
Okay. Well, that's great.
So...
I know we did this on Mod Envy, but let's do this anyway. Let's talk vape mail. I gotta do vape mail again. Mm-hmm. Since you have only a few things, why don't we start with you?
Now, I did not bring what I...
Uh-oh.
No, I didn't bring it to the desk because we talked about it on Mod Envy, so I didn't bring it here.
I have it in my hand, though.
Well, so you can tell yours and I'll talk. Hush now.
I'll just do that.
Okay.
Now you can talk.
Okay, good. Just checking, you know, because, like, if you just want to interrupt, I was just going to let you go, man. SX Mini, that was the big news this week, and I'm really pleased with it. Now, I didn't get a chance before tonight to really put it through its paces. I had plans. I was going to build the squape for it and see what I thought. That didn't happen. My tree is up, so, you know, it's about, you know, different things, right? So, what I will say is, so far I've been very impressed with how it operates, how it works. I'm a little fuzzy still on the operation. We have to talk a little bit more. But VapeRo Supply was so kind as to send one for me to check out, and that's what I've been doing. beautifully made. Attention to detail. One of the crispest, most informative displays I've seen on a mod like that. Overall, so far, I'm real pleased. Now, one of the things I think is really, really cool about this mod. Now, we did talk about this a little on Mod Envy, but if you'll indulge me, I'd like to share in case some of you weren't there. The fact is, way back when the EVIC came out, they did something kind of cool. And with the use of software and cabling the mod to your computer, and a bunch of convoluted stuff, right? And you had to really kind of learn and know what you were doing. You could program your own vape. And I liken it to a power curve, really. You could decide, do I want my vape to start small and get hotter, or do I want it to start with a bang and then drop off? So you could do that. What they've done, now I don't know a lot of people who did. I know a lot of people were excited about it and talked about it. I didn't hear a lot of people actually doing it. And it was not necessarily a really straightforward process. I think they got it right with the SX Mini. You know, most people who vape don't also want to be computer programmers. There's the exception, right? But what they did with the SX Mini is they said, well, okay, rather than have you hook it up and program your own curve, we're going to give you three out of the box. So you've got standard, soft, and powerful. And I've been using that puppy since it showed up on the powerful mode. And I will say this, I think it fires the same dripper on a mechanical and on this, and the crazy wattages either, fired quicker. It started to produce vapor quicker because the powerful mode hits it a little harder at first to fire that coil, get it nice and hot, and then it backs off and you vape. So it's kind of neat in that respect. If you prefer a little bit of a gentler vape, you know, you can maybe choose the soft. Normal is probably what you're accustomed to all the time anyway. Battery life, big bamboo. Let me put it this way. I haven't used it enough. I've been testing it with a dripper on it. I've been using the Smoketech X Pure on it. And that is coming in at 0.6, just hair under 0.6. And I haven't had to charge it yet. I did trickle charge it this afternoon just because it was getting lower and I wanted to be able to, you know, use it earlier. But it really, it's been 2 days. It's hard for me because I never just vape one thing and run it down. I've got different things on the go. I'll pick this up, I'll vape that for a while, I'll pick this up and vape that for a while. So when somebody asks me how long does the battery last, I'm always at a bit of a loss to tell you. I don't know, but it seems like a long time. Of course, it's going to depend what wattage you're running it at, what you're doing with it, what you're running on it. So it's a hard question to answer, but I would say so far it seems pretty efficient.
Yeah, now I actually have, somebody put in the room, what do you think of the Atlantis? Well, I have the Atlantis on my SX Mini running at 45 watts in soft. I really don't know. So let's change it to, I think it's, okay. Now it's in normal mode. So I'm at 45 watts on the SX Mini with the Atlantis. Now let me explain something to you. This is hold that up again. Okay, so I'm holding it up again. SX Mini with the Atlantis is a perfect combo. It just doesn't get any better than this. You would think I'm rebuilding with the clouds that I'm going to get off this. You're going to be shocked in the mix. I mean, that's just a... just the film bit.
So that was part of my vape mail, and we kind of agreed on Mod Envy that vape mail doesn't have to necessarily show up delivered by the postal service. This can be something you picked up. Well, in a manner of speaking, I guess I kind of acquired a vape accoutrement just today, and I wanted to share with you, and I wanted to thank Big Bam Boob. He had the privilege of choosing a new emoticon to use here at Vapors TV, and you guys have already seen it. Some of you are using it. That yes, Togavot, that's exactly right. The little tiger, and he tells me they're actually going to change it, so it's my name the way I spell it. And I was just so touched. It was so cute. So thank you so much, Big Bam. So thoughtful, and it's the cutest little tiger ever. So thank you.
Oh, that is nice. I like that.
isn't he cute?
So is it just right now in is it just tiger?
Tiger, the way you spell it in the zoo. Yep.
Okay. Everybody put tigers in the room.
I was so touched by that. That's so cute. When he said he was going to pick one out, I was like, oh, cool. You'll have to, you know, pick something, you know, befitting a Link Ninja. I had no idea he had that up his sleeve. So that was really sweet. Made my day. Thank you.
Very, very cool. Very, very cool. All right. So let's start with some deals. I mean, we're already 20 minutes in. I mean, this went quick. We're already 20 minutes in.
Yeah.
I mean, one second here.
Yeah,
I'm
on next.
I'm working and as much as I am talking. I gotta talk about my date mail. Jesus.
Mm-hmm. I thought so you wanted to skip it. I was just going with it.
I know, really? Like, okay, so let's do this. I'm gonna make it quick though. I sent Tiger a monster package. So she's gonna be getting some amazing date mail in the next few days. I sent her a Mutation X version 2. I sent her a Atlantis. I cannot wait till she tries this motherfucker. She's gonna love this. I tell you right now, the moment you try an Atlantis is the moment you throw every capon you own away. You don't need a capon when you have an Atlantis. Unless you're going below 0.5 ohms on a capon, you don't need an Atlantis. Now, Tiger, you're with me on this. Most people don't build capons that low.
That low? No, the capon is typically viewed and considered a flavor atomizer. It's not so much about going real low ohms and getting clouds. That's not why you use a capon. You use a capon because you want a convenient vape, you don't want to be dripping, and you want great flavor.
The Atlantis is unbelievable. Now, somebody says in there that the sub-tank might be better. I tell you, you may be right about that. Son of Sam, vagina. There's nothing.
There's no emoticon for that.
And I'm sure Miss Scruffy would not give you one with that name. Hey, Big Bamboo, you put that in there. I don't see my Vapor Joe's in there. So it doesn't count. At least I don't think it does. Oh, wait. Oh, there's a fuck ton in there.
Now, Gay Vapor is asking, is it hard to build, Joe? Now, are you talking about the Atlantis, Gay Vapor? Because the Atlantis doesn't get built, so it's really easy.
Oh, it is in there. Yeah, there's no, you don't build. Yeah. Yeah, you don't build the Atlantis.
There are heads available for the Atlantis in 0.5, 0.8, and 1, I think it's 1 ohm. I think that's right. So it is intended for a more aggressive vape. You're getting down lower, but it's all pre-done heads. Now, you know, it's only a matter of time if somebody hasn't already learned how to rebuild them. That's going to happen. But yeah, it is a pre-made.
Atlantis, actually, Tiger, is a standard head is 0.5 ohms. Standard. And for those of you who don't want to rebuild, if you want to vape and blow clouds, you can do it on the Atlantis and look like you're a rebuilder. Like, what they should do is make this a solid metal tank and people would think it was some kind of atomizer, because you blow such huge clouds with the Atlantis that it makes, it's like cloud chasers don't need to rebuild anymore. It's that fucking crazy. It is that crazy. Now, anyway, getting back to bait mail, I got a boatload of juice from Yalik. Now, since we are technically an international flavor when it comes to vapors, Jaelic is a wonderful place to buy your juice. For those of you who live internationally or you know, in the United States, 100 mils of juice will cost you just now on his special. 100 mils of juice is just $10, and then there's a $10 flat rate shipping. But that is if you buy, you know, one bottle of juice or 100 bottles of juice, it's going to cost you $10 out of Israel. He sent me this juice called Morning Babe. Okay, you see that? See that bottle right there? No, I'm going to turn it around. I got this 3 days ago. This is 100 mils of juice. See how far down that's gone already? Now, what this is I like coffee, okay? I'm a coffee vapor. Not everybody is, but this is different. What he did is he took coffee with sugar, combined it with waffles, maple syrup, and butter. So basically, you just made the best waffles and syrup and butter that you've ever eaten, and then in the second hand, you took your sweet coffee and you drank it, and it just combines in your mouth. It is that good. Oh my God, it's incredible. That's what I'm vaping in this right now. It's just that good. And then he sent me a t-shirt, a big dripper. I'm going to probably send that off to Tiger to try out. And this really cool beer bottle opener with the Jaelic symbol on it. And a few other little tchotchkes, and very grateful for that. And then I got a big package from Enjoy, which is the limited edition dripper juice line that has it from different manufacturers like Good Life Vapor and stuff. I haven't really horsed into that yet, but it's so pretty. I don't even want to open it, to be honest with you. I don't even want to open it. I mean, if you look at the box that I got, I mean, the big guy who put the link in the room, I don't even want to open these bottles of juice. They're so gorgeous. It's like something I just want to put away. And then I got that beautiful mod stand, but I gave that away on Mod Envy, along with a few bottles of juice. And I got two Vapor Sharks. One's going out to a winner from a few weeks ago. And then I have one other Vapor Shark that I'm going to be giving away sometime in the future. Probably maybe the Christmas show or maybe sometime on Done Deal. I haven't really decided yet. And then what else did I get? And then Smoke Signal sent me a monster bottle, a box of juice that I haven't even, I just opened and looked at it. I haven't really got into the juice yet. So I had a ton of available. Not much hardware, lots of juice, but I have to tell you, so far, Tiger got her SX Mini. I am really impressed with one. I've been using mine for about 2 weeks now. Fantastic. If you can get one, get one.
Yeah, I would concur. It's beautifully made, well put together. It's got weight to it. It's not crazy heavy, but it's got weight. It's got substance. It feels like it's made of something, you know? So, Vape and Chevy, Brothers Juice Company. Yes, you may. Thank you for asking. And now there was a question about the sub tank earlier. I'm not ignoring you, but we let Joe finish his bait mail. Let me ask you to just hang on, because we're going to get to the sub tank in short order. But I want to start with something that when it popped, I got really excited. Let's talk about this right here. There we go. And there is the link, and here is where is it? There it is. The billet box has been cloned, and for $60. Now, if you're familiar with billet box, you're looking at between $200 and $235, $240 for a billet box. Okay. So this is a significant savings. Now, if you can get a billet box, well, they're somewhat readily available now, but, you know, still not super easy. You don't just, you know, go online any day and pick from 30, you know, like it's a weekly thing. But in any case, you know, will this measure up? Will this stack up? I am dying for the first reviews to start rolling in and for consumers to let us know what their experiences are. But I will say this, I pored over the pictures with a fine-tooth comb, and they looks like they did a really nice job. A lot of attention to detail here. Now, the really cool part about this is there are two styles available. You'll notice I'm going to come over here with my mouse and I'm going to show you something. The brown one is the typical billet box we know from way back when, okay? It's got the tank, it's got the cartomizer, drip tipped in the top. You've got a beautiful, portable, non-leaking, reliable, awesome, convenient base. Great flavor. But the one that really got me excited is the other one, the silver and carbon fiber. That's a carbon fiber front and back on them. As you can see in this image here, the back slides away and exposes. There's your battery compartment there. This is the tank that holds your juice. But instead of a cartomizer, there is a clever device for the originals. Is it Atmistique that made the billet bridge? Now, the billet bridge allows you, instead of using the cartomizers, you can use the Aspire head. You can put a BVC or a BV or a BDC in there. Just changes the game, because we all know that was a huge advancement. They perform beautifully, and in the billet box, they are just wonderful. So using the Aspire head, you're getting a fabulous vape. The clever little device that comes with, the bridge-like device, allows you to use those heads. Same price, like $60. So that's pretty cool. Now, there is a little gotcha on these. They use a non-standard battery size. This is taking two 16-340s. So, you know, if you're like me and you're like, well, what the heck? I don't know from 16-340. You know, I've heard of other sizes, but what uses that? Well, no problem. Click the link. I'm going to give it to you again. We also sourced you a good deal on batteries, so we got you covered, okay? And so billet box, possibly a quarter of the price of the original.
Right. Now, you know, I always said that the billet box is the original e-grip. Now, you guys know the Joytech e-grip. Oh, I got one right here.
Hitman 420. Part of me wants to just say no to will it take an RDA. But there are RDAs that might work. What I'm thinking of, and I don't know if it would work or not, you've got my gears turning now. There was something, what the heck, was that the Diver? And there was a clone of it as well. Now the Diver allowed you to use a normal cardo tank, but instead of using cartomizers, it was a rebuildable device that went in. Pretty clever. Okay, MileT, Z28, thank you very much. He's saying Diver and a Sophia. Now, I don't even know what that one is. You made some homework for me. I'm going to have to look into it. But Diver and Sophia should fit. So there you go. I guess Hitman, I gotta eat my words. It will take an RDA. You just have to have the right one. Because, of course, your atomizer is in tank in this one. So you can't just, you haven't got a 510 connector on top. You don't just screw something onto it. Top, what you're seeing here is actually not a 510 connector in there on top of the brown one. Okay, that's where your drip tip goes. And it shows you that on the silver one here. You've got just the drip tip sticking up right there.
Right.
Everything else is in tank.
The billet box is a unique design. I mean, the billet box has been around a while. The billet box, somebody puts in a volt. I think it goes to 5.5 volts. Basically, you change the voltage with a little wheel in there. I mean, this is a self-contained unit. Basically, if for those of you who don't understand how this works, either the Cardo or the Aspire head goes inside that little acrylic tank. That whole tank is filled with juice, and then you close the billet box, and then the drip tip goes on top, so everything's like self-contained. It's a lot like the e-grip, but the e-grip came out way after the billet box. So basically the e-grip is what the billet box, like the e-grip wants to grow up to be the billet box. I mean, this is just the baby version of the billet box.
Alrighty. Well, apparently I made a mistake, and thank you for correcting me, Bastard. He's telling me the brass fitting is threaded on the brown model. So the older style that was made for the cartomizer, I guess they thought ahead to allow you to do that. I don't know how that would connect. I don't understand how that works. Like, what's it going to connect to? But I'll take your word for that one. I'm still learning about the billet boxes. This is kind of a new thing. They've been out forever, but I've never been interested until recently. So And then, of course, the clone comes out right when I'm getting interested. Oh, isn't that handy?
So, yeah, get over there and check out the Villa Box. I think I may get one of these. I don't know which one I'm going to get. I think the brown one is actually way, way, way sexier than the original. I mean, the one that's using the bridge is the original, which is kind of funny because the original should have the card out. The brown one should have the bridge because the brown one is a newer version. So I may actually get the brown one simply because of the look. You know? So all in all, though, I think it's an absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous model.
Alrighty. Well, let's move on. I do have another one I wanted to talk about right off the top for you guys. Just totally switch gears. We'll go from devices to juice. Now, those of you who are familiar with my vape habits know that a vast majority, really, of what gets vaped at my desk is the SV creation. The tagline, damn good e-juice, is absolute truth. Blended in Bruno, Saskatchewan, out in the middle of nowhere, and from the finest ingredients, he has just set up the operations in a beautiful brand new facility, totally outfitted with like the best quality, you know, clean kitchen or like medical standard equipment, you know, like just a really awesome, well thought out location. And now he wants to give us a little thank you. It's his Christmas holiday bonus special, 25% off until the end of December. And in his own words, he says, thank you for helping me build this business. And it's been a very action-packed year for him, growing at breakneck speed. Get yourself some DSV. I highly recommend the Phantasm orange, sort of creamsicle and orange ice cream flavor. Really nice, with a little tiny bit of a licorice twist. Actually, I shouldn't say tiny. There's a fair bit, but it's not overpowering. It's just nice. So give that a shot. There's lots of other great flavors. I'm particularly fond of the chocolate waterfall, a chocolate mint flavor, which is really nice for winter. It always reminds me of hot chocolate with peppermint schnapps, so that's an enjoyable one too. But yeah, sugar cookie and strawberry cupcake, another two of the top favorites. If you like strawberry kind of creamy, like the strawberry milkshake, a really nice, rich, creamy strawberry milkshake, you got to check out. Oh, and now my mind just went blank. Wabbit Season. Wabbit Season is that one. And people are going absolutely bananas over Little Vixen lately, too. So there's a few to start with. But, I mean, read through, see what matches your flavor profiles. And of course, there is a Facebook group too. Let me grab the Facebook group, because if you're just not sure about flavors, it's always nice to head on over there and ask the people that vape that stuff every day. They can make tons of recommendations for you that might match your palate better than mine does. So there you go. There is the Facebook group for DSV Creations.
Awesome songs.
And Big Bam shared the link there again. To get the 25% off, just check out that blog post. We've got the coupon code in there for you and a direct link to take you straight to DSV.
So. All right. Let's talk all things eLeaf iStick. Hold on. I have to get back in the room.
Paloma, DSV Creations ships worldwide. Wherever vapors vape, he'll send juice.
All right, so you can get yourself an eLeaf iStick, the original iStick, this one everybody loves so much, the 20 watt one. You can get it for $31.49 with a bottle, and you also get a bottle of Millennium juice with that. So that's $31.49, and you get a free 10 ml bottle of juice. Now, normally these are like $34-$35, but use coupon code JOE10 and you will get 10% off your total order. And for those of you who want to get one of your loved ones a really, really nice gift for Christmas, I mean, these are tiny. These are stocking stuffers, okay?
Yeah.
A mod in the stocking. Think about it. You know, some people are thinking, oh, you're going to put candy in there, shaving cream, razors, dumb bullshit, blah, blah, blah. Throw an eye stick in there. Makes somebody happy.
Especially, you know, for somebody who's expressed interest in vaping or has started and is using stick batteries, this is an absolute... I recommend this to beginners all the time because I know it's got a little bit more flexibility, a little more, you know, options, a little more life in it than a stick battery. So it makes a great starter device. It makes a great addition to your collection. It's great even, like, I've got a lot of really nice devices to use, and I do constantly. But I love having one of these. Well, all right, let's be honest. I love having two of these on hand because they're just so great to take with you. And at the end of the day, I'm sorry, you know, it's not that I don't want to take care of all my stuff or lose something, but if something's going to get dropped, stolen, or, you know, backed over or lost, I would sure sooner it's this than some of the other tools I enjoy using. So, definitely a great little device. And they have the wraps for them out already, too, so you can dress it up however you like.
All right, now I'm going to throw in a link just for... shits and giggles as far as something new that's coming out. The current price on these I don't like, but I'm throwing the post in as in the informative post rather than the place you can actually buy it. This is called the iStick Mini. There's a new trend coming in the vaping community. I'm telling you this now. It's making everything smaller, and here you can see it. There's the IPV Mini. The Smoke Tech blah 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 mini, we have the iStick Mini, everything's mini now, mini. Now, in terms of practicality, this mod isn't practical, and you know, Tiger will tell you this mod is not practical. In terms of size and form, this mod is great. It's a 10 watt mod, has a 1050 mAh battery in it. It's like a 18500. I think, or an 18350, something really small. Goes to 10 watts, but it's tiny. It's only 2.1 inches tall.
It's a toy. And I said I would be hard on it. Well, let me be honest. I think there's a place for it. It's a toy. If you just want something really cute, really tiny, 10 watts is enough. Please don't make this your only device. Don't get this instead of an iStick. You know, don't do that, because for the price difference, I could in no way in good conscience recommend a mini over the full iStick to anyone. But if you already have an iStick or something similar, you just want a nice little portable and you think they're cute, yeah, okay, go for the 10 watt. But if you're choosing between, there is no decision point. You get the 20 watt, you get the full one, and you've got something that's going to last you all day, 2200 mAh under the hood, and offer you 20 watts instead of 10. So there's more room to grow. There's more you can do. If you get into more aggressive vapes, it's still going to perform for you. Vampire, right. Exactly, $27. If they were selling the mini for 15, I'd buy them all day long.
Yes, you know, now... The you know, I look at it in terms of something like, you guys remember something called the Gripper back from Mad Babes had it. It was called the Gripper. Basically, it was a 18350 battery. It took a carbonizer, you hit the top button and you vaped it, and it was real tiny. That was a $15 mod, and that just used battery. There was no wattage or voltage or anything. In good conscience, no. $27 when you can buy the big boy for $31, no. I think if these can come down to under $20, like $19.99 plus shipping, I think it would be a good deal. $27, they're new. But at the same time, I love the idea of a tiny stealth vape. You know, 2.1 inches, it's like this big. I mean, it's literally nothing. Mm-hmm. So... Now, people are like, you know, $10. You got to remember, there's a level of manufacturing that's involved in this. You can't. Yeah. It's never going to happen for $10. It's just not. $20. I know vendor costs on these are like $15, so they have to make money. You know what I mean? A vendor can't spend $15 and sell it for $19. It's just not going to happen because you're going to have a level of returns in there. they have to pay shipping. So there's, it's just not going to happen until, unless you have an MOQ of like 10,000 and you can get it for $12, sure. But, Joe, the Gripper is in stock and it's at Man Boom. Yeah, for $8. But you're right, Big Man Boom, but that wasn't what it was back in the day. Now it's $8 because nobody wants them. But back in the day, they were $15-$20 and people were buying all day long. But again, this mod is for stealth. This mod is not for your all day. You're all there.
Retroxify, I love your comment. I totally am there with you. It would take me 7 seconds to lose that thing in my couch cushions. I love it. And there it'll be with the remotes and some random peanuts. Anyway. Alrighty. How am I doing, Tiger? Is this Sinister Paloma? I'm doing fabulous. Thank you for asking. How are you doing? You enjoying your Saturday night here at Vapors TV on VU Live? I hope so. All right. We've done a bunch of talking about the Atlantis. Let's talk about an Atlantis deal. Now, before we go any further, let me make one thing very clear. This is the replica Atlantis. So that's why you're seeing such a compelling price. That comes, of course, with the 0.5 ohm head in there. And we've got a link in the deal as well for the replacement heads. And you know what? I might have been... No, that wasn't sub-tank. Yeah, I was right. These ones are available in 0.5, 0.8, and 1. So earlier at the top of the show when we were talking about the resistances available, there you go. Three different ones. And a 5-pack for $6.29. Now, I am just dying to hear from users again. Whoever gets these first, I don't know if it's going to be me or you, but whoever gets them first, report in, because I want to know how the replica heads, replacement heads, compare, stack up to the originals. And, of course, the unit itself as well. What we are seeing more and more, and what I've observed over a little over two years of vaping, is the gap between the quality of the originals and the replicas is getting smaller and smaller. There's those who would cry foul to hear me say that, but I think we got to be honest. Early replicas of successful products, in a lot of cases, were okay. Sometimes they were so-so. Sometimes they really just plain sucked. Right. More and more we're seeing that gap closing, and you know, maybe the original is a little polished, shinier, but other than that, yeah, can't tell the difference. So, you know, I like getting more for my money. If I can't tell the difference, you know what I'm gonna do.
Well, most of these are made, for those of you who don't know this, most of these are made in the same factories.
Yeah. They just leave in a different box. Other than that, there's nothing different.
Yeah, pretty much.
And that's what makes me laugh so hard when people cling to things, especially on products where we have a pretty good indication that that's exactly what's happening. And the purists are out there beating their drums and waving their fists and, oh, you know, I tried the copy and they were no good. Those replacement heads are no good. They are terrible. And it's kind of like, it came off the same line, buddy. They were made 15 minutes apart. Really, but you know, anyway, it's subjective, just like everything in vaping, right? So they're entitled to their opinion.
I think the name brands may go through an extra one person of quality control,
quality check, for sure. Yeah. I could see
other than that, I think they're exactly the same.
You know, Joe, for the price savings, you know, I don't know, what would a reasonable fail rate be? Maybe like, I don't know, 1%, 2%.
Never had a fail rate. You know, people, I remember back in the cartomizer days, people would talk about, oh, their cardo, this cardo died, that cardo. I never had these fucking problems. Smokey's no. Like, oh, a cardo lasts me a day. Fucking cardo would last me a week.
Yeah.
I don't know what $2 hooker is sucking on your fucking mod to blow out your cardo in fucking a day, but, I just don't see it. You know, like, I never had these problems. You know, I've never had, like, oh, I put a, I've never had a bad ProTank head. I've never had a bad anything, you know. I've never had, how about this? I have never had bad head.
Well, I look at it this way. I like to play the numbers game. And we've said, you know, 1-2% fail rate. Well, let's go, like, for broke and say that the replacement head clones have a 3% fail rate. Ooh. You know what? Dollar for dollar, I'll throw out those 3% and still be ahead.
Exactly.
So.
Pass Dub says, has never had bad head. You know what? Anyway.
Okay. We'll leave it there. So
he's like easy.
All right. So Atlantis clone. Now I made you a promise, Joe. Just forgive me, but I'm going to forge ahead with one more because these two kind of go together. I wanted to talk about these together, so we're going to go for it. Oh, and yeah, there he is, Big Bam. You mind reader, you. We're going to talk about the Kanger sub tank next, okay? This is the Kanger tank. It's a also sub-ohm intended tank. Comes with a revolutionary new head. It's a square. They're calling it a BPDC bottom. Oh, I don't know. Dual coil. What's the P for? I don't know. It's a mystery.
I don't know, because the holes on those fucking heads are. You see the holes on.
Oh yeah, on the side here, the amount. But I mean, it's going to be an aggressive. They have to let it wick easy to have it work. Now, here's what I've been saying. Now, I haven't gotten to try this yet. I haven't gotten to try the Atlantis either. We're getting there. But Aspire has been on the bleeding edge. They've been doing incredible things all through 2014. Very impressed. The Nautilus changed the game. The mini Nautilus changed it again. And now, of course, coming out with the Atlantis, it's just leaps and bounds, folks. Kanger has been behind. They're always sort of releasing behind Aspire. But I'll tell you what Kanger's got going for them that Aspire needs to take a lesson in. This is drop-dead sexy. And I felt that way about the Mega Tank, too. The Mega Tank just blows the Nautilus away for looks. Okay, so you can't vape the looks. But hey, you want your setup to look good, too, right? And this right. tank is drop-dead sexy. Now, and this one, by the way, is the authentic. It is coming at a good price point from overseas, but this is the real McCoy. So that's why you're seeing that bigger price tag. Really nice thick glass on this. Great looks, lots of airflow. And here's where it gets just even better. You want the icing on the cake? Here it is. You can use the BPDCs, the square pre-made heads that we're showing here, or this little unit comes with it as well. That's a rebuildable. You can basically use your sub tank in like as a K-Fun-esque setup, if you will. Because that's what you've got. You've got a gravity-fed bottom coil rebuildable using the rebuildable head. Now, is that genius or what? Here's where I think that's really going to be awesome. When you've rebuilt it, you love your build, but you're going away for the weekend, take a pack of spare heads with you, or at least a couple of them with you. If something goes wrong, if your build goes snarky, if you break a wire, if you haven't got time to rebuild, no problem. You throw the pre-made head in and you enjoy your vape probably almost as much anyway. Cool? I think so. I think it's brilliant. It also gives a new person who's not comfortable rebuilding somewhere to go. They can start with the pre-made heads, see how it goes. Now they're interested in, you know, learning to build. Go for it. There you go. You've got it right built in there. So. Arc Redneck, and I wonder if somebody else has mentioned it. I'm sorry, I was kind of glancing around, so I didn't catch everything in chat. Ready Xwick talking about, I've been hearing from people using it that they think that would be all kinds of win with this atomizer. So let me know. Let me know what you find.
Absolutely. Yeah, now, this was a prediction of mine. There's a big blog out of the UK that talks about predictions. They grab the minds of the industry and they ask, you know, what are your predictions for the next year? And my predictions for 2014 was that this would be the year of the 26650, and so on and so on. And like I'd say 90% of my predictions came true. Everybody was talking about how the FDA was going to shut down the industry this year, and there was a whole bunch of bullshit. So next year, for 2015, my prediction is you're going to see a lot more of what I call hybrid omizers. That's what the sub-tank is, where you can do a fill and vape, or you could put a rebuildable in there. And I think from sub-tank forward, you're going to start seeing that. And you can already see it, because things like the e-grip, like the little e-grip from Joytech, they're putting rebuildable heads in those. I guarantee you, within the next month or so, you're going to start seeing rebuildable heads for the Atlantis. I guarantee it. It's gonna happen. Because rather than them making a whole new tank system, they'll make a head that will fit this, that will be a rebuildable.
That'll be rebuild friendly, as opposed to the way people like do workarounds and figure out how to rebuild a pre-made head. These will be designed for it.
Right.
Scarlet Cheddar, who's your coupon code for? And okay, thank you to the people. It started with Cheesecloth. Z28, I see your comment. Retroxify, talking about the OCC, the organic cotton coil. Now, I apologize. I thought the two terms, the BPDC and the OCC, were actually just iterations of the same thing. See, I learned from you guys, too. I love this, and thank you. So you're telling me now that actually they are two different things, and the OCC, the organic cotton coil, has replaced the BPDC, the bottom plane. Thank you, Oscar, for that. Dual coil. So there you go. So that's one advantage of these as well, in my opinion, is the fact that they're using the organic cotton. Now, I have been reading some different things about concerns about them. I'm reserving comment at this point. Not enough is known. Maybe I would just say, make darn sure that you don't end up with a dry hit. Keep juice in your tank. Let your coil wick.
I'll tell you straight up, I think it's just somebody trying to make a name for themselves.
Well, time will flesh that out. But right now, I wouldn't feel right if I didn't mention it. But at this point, I would not say, it would not prevent me from using it. Let me put it that way. And I can be a little concerned about some things. Like, you still won't find a copper Addy in my collection. Anywho. All right. Joe, I've been talking for a while. Do you wanna share a deal?
Yeah, sure. I had one in stock. Well, I had one I wanted to do, but it's out of stock, so I can't do that one. Where are we at here? There we go. Okay, finally. All right, you know what it is? Is I'm trying to. A lot of deals I put up have gone out of stock, so. There we go. Atlantis. We've been talking about the Atlantis, so boom, there you go. $31.99 gets you an Atlantis tank from 101 Vape, international friendly, well, Canadian friendly and American friendly. For those of you who haven't tried the Atlantis, this is a really good deal at $31.99. Now, again, I have to show you this. I'm not using a rebuildable here. I'm using a simple fill and vape, okay? I just opened it up, dumped juice in, closed it up. It took no effort, nothing. This is equivalent of a pro tank, nothing. Now, John Q Public puts $29.95 at Vape NW. Check the shipping difference. See, when we do deals, you have to look at the shipping. If somebody's like, oh, it's $31.99 with $1.99 shipping, or $29.95 with $5 shipping, guess what? Big difference.
The more expensive one is sometimes the better deal.
Exactly. Somebody just put in there, it's $6 to ship. So, all right. So anyway, check it out. I mean, this is just.
Yeah, definitely. When you are ordering online, and this goes for everything. This goes for electronics, clothes, whatever it is you're ordering online, vape gear. You always have to factor the shipping, because that's going to be really key. Free shipping can often make a more expensive product the better deal.
Right. Now, also, you know, it's not just shipping. Also, you got to look at, you know, if it's a dollar to difference, I also go with quality. Like, if somebody's $29.99 and it's blah 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 vape, and then I can go to 101 vape and get it for $30.99. It's a dollar more. I'm going to go to 101 vape. Why? Because I know their style. I know their how fast they ship. You know, for a buck, I'll trade up for a dollar, just because I know that they're a better vendor. You know, cheaper isn't always better, and FastTech is a prime example of that. There are plenty of people out there that don't shop at FastTech because it takes a long time to get their stuff, and even though sometimes it's 30% cheaper because they want it now. Mm-hmm. So what I like to do is I talk to vendors or I buy from vendors, and if a vendor is a buck more or $1.50 more, I may go with them only because I know I'll get it in a couple days. You know, that's just how you have to do it. And stock level is the next thing. You know, there are vendors out there that are cheaper sometimes than what I put up on my blog. But I can't, if you have 25 in stock, I can't put you on my blog. Yeah. Because I'll get more hate. You know, it's like, oh yeah, you're cheaper, but you're going to last all of like fucking 20 minutes when I put you up on my blog. So I can't do that. Mm-hmm. You know, so that's the other disadvantage of having a popular blog, because if you put something up with low stock levels, you get more hate mail. You know, you get more people angry at you than happy with you.
Bud Johnson, I see your comment. We're talking about, you know, longer delivery times from overseas. Bud, you're absolutely right. He's saying the USA can take longer to deliver than China to Canada. And you're absolutely correct. You know, Vapro Supply knows how to ship. But it took a lot longer for the FX Mini to show up to me from, now what is that, Joe, Texas?
Yeah.
It took a lot longer for the SX Mini to get here from Texas than it did for two Valkyries to come all the way from China. 6 days, folks. 6 days. I ordered these Saturday night after the show 2 weeks ago. Friday night, 8 days ago, I had them. 6 days, China.
Yeah, so it's all very relative, you know. So that's just, you know, I trust 101 Vape. You know, it's $31.99. Some places have it, you know, $29. But you got to factor shipping costs. And, you know, and you also have to factor in vendor reputation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it's not a deal if you're never going to get it. That's a bad deal. All right.
So,
well,
who has the best deal on the rebuildable heads for it? Nope, there's no rebuildable heads for the Atlantis.
Yeah, right now there are people rebuilding these. Son of Sam, the Valkyries were actually from Desire Isig. There, it's on the blog a little bit back. If you just head over to vaporjoes.ca and search Valkyrie, you'll come up with it probably quicker than I can do right now with all the junk on my screen. Okay. Well, I have something. We're going to really switch gears again. Like some days, just depending what popped that week, I got a lot of mechanicals to show you. Some days I got a lot of atomizers. This week, it was just kind of all over the place. We got something really different here. I'm going to grab the link first. And you've seen, you know, tons of new styles of box mods coming out, coming available. A lot of people are doing it themselves. Now, I'm not saying just anybody should run out and grab a soldering iron and put together a mod. I mean, know what you're doing, understand electricity, get some instructions. You know, if you're somebody who's already inclined that way, there's a lot you can do. And here's some tools to help you do it. A really great source, a really great cheap source for nice quality components. You've got the spring-loaded switches, stainless steel. That's a 21.7 millimeter switch there, I think, if I recall correctly. And what I'm calling a premium connector. Of course, these are not Fad Daddy connectors, but they're definitely, obviously, inspired by them. And, you know, roughly $4 for the components is a sweet price. It's actually, you know, if you are inclined that way and you're good at soldering and you do understand how to safely put together something like this, it's kind of fun to do, inexpensive, very effective, and you can create a one-off for yourself or your friends, you know? So something to think about if you're DIY inclined.
Yeah, I was really, really excited when I saw this because, you know, for a while, you know, premium 510 connectors were always self, you know, pretty much the only one who had the lock on it was Fat Daddy. Now, I'm not against Fat Daddy connectors. I think they're great, but they're also like, you know, anywhere $7 to $10 a piece. Here, you're getting a pretty equivalent for $4. And those fucking shitty HANA buttons out there, drive, Tiger, you have an Aspire, I don't know, for whatever reason, but there's an Aspire covering your picture.
Yeah, I turned on a layer that wasn't supposed to be. Let's make short work of it.
When you look at those buttons that people are using on their box mods, those shitty tactile fire buttons, I fucking hate them. They're little you know what it's like? It's like a woman on a bad date. They got these wonderful huge boxes, they have amazing wattage, and then you turn it around, you rather fire it, and it's this little teeny baby button. It's like quack, quack. It's terrible. You know, it's absolutely terrible. It's like, I hate them. I hate those little teeny baby buttons. Where, you know, now you can get a really good horn switch, stainless steel horn switch for five, you know, $4. You get your awesome connector for $3, and then you put it in your box mod, and it's just ready to roll.
Thanks for the link, Big Bam, and Son of Sam, Big Bam found it for you there. Now, I do apologize. The deal is an older deal. It was a Black Friday deal, so the price isn't correct in that deal anymore. That was a limited special, but you're going to find the price is still very compelling compared to what you can get them for. And now that I have them in hand, I feel like I totally got my money's worth. It's a great little mod. Really beautiful. For those of you wondering, we all know how the original Valkyries had problems with the switches. EH Pro ironed that out when they made the copy. One of those scenarios where the copy is actually superior to the original. And I'll tell you right now, the button on this, I've been using it for a week now. The button on it has yet to get warmer than my hand makes it. It is a great little unit. I'm very, very pleased. Great flavor. Great flavor. And even the way I built it, and trust me, I built it weird. I was just experimenting. I put two stovetop coils in it. I need to drop the resistance. I need to cut a little off those and do it again. But the concept is working great. All right.
All right, so let's talk things MVP. Boom. Now, everybody's talking about this MVP. Now, I'm calling this the MVP3. And I got, you know, Anokin hit me up. It's not the MVP3. I said, well, fuck you. Yes, it is. Because it's the version 3 of the MVP. I don't want to hear it. This is number 3 MVP. We had the, you know, original MVP. Then we had the second incarnation of the MVP. And now we have this one. It's called the MVP21. And I think what it is because Anokin wants to call MVP3... 3 because it's probably going to be 30 watts. But I'm sorry, but this is the third, you know, in line, so I'm calling it the V3. I've seen prices on this in the range of like $30, $35. I'm kind of on the fence on this one. I don't know about you, Tiger, but
I'm a little on the fence too, Joe. I think what price is this one coming in at?
$34.99,
between $34 and $39. Oh, okay. So it's under $40. Well,
right.
You know, okay. If it was going to be over 40 or closer to 50, I'd be kind of like, too little, too late. Sorry. But at that price point, okay. There's a viable case to be made.
The only problem I have with this is like, we'll just get an iStick.
Yeah. See, that's exactly where I'm at. Now, the iStick isn't going to charge your phone. But, come on, really? How many of us actually did that? I thought it was super cool. I thought it was a huge selling point. I was like, yeah, I can charge my phone. I never did.
Yeah, so Baby of Hood's in a room. There's, yeah, $39. You know, I like the idea of it, but I can't justify, you know, and the wattage on this is not Like, it goes to 20 watts, but in 0.5 watt increments. It doesn't do it like what we're used to nowadays, where it's 0.1. So they're using a little bit older tech and wattage. Now, it goes to 7.5 volts, which is interesting. Mm-hmm. But generally speaking, I don't know if I'm a fan yet, because there's so much better wattage devices out there. Like I said, the iStick, where you can get it for, you know, $31. Why am I spending $40 on this? Okay, it's bigger, it's beefier. I could charge my cell phone with it, but how many people have charged their fucking cell phones with their MVP? Honestly, has anybody in this room ever charged their phone with their fucking MVP?
I have heard from a viewer. Absolutely, I loved being able to do that. Oh, okay. Well, you're the person then they built this for. Awesome. I'm glad it exists for you. But when it came down to a decision point of doing that, it's like, I'm out. I have my phone. I have my vape. And it's like, well, yeah, I don't want my phone to die, but I don't want my vape to die before I get home either.
Exactly.
I don't want to sacrifice that.
Like, my business partner, her MVP died completely, like the 510, the whole stick. Okay. And she's like, I want to throw it away. I'm like, no, don't throw it away, because that's a cell phone charger.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. If you're just going to use it as a battery to charge, great. But, I mean, if I have to sacrifice, do I charge my phone or vape?
I know, right? It's like, never mind, I'll answer my calls later. I want my vape.
So MTL 1Z28 says, so the MVP 3 will have a 30 watt, will be the evolved chipset then. Let me tell you something. Every time Anokin tries to come out, look at the SVD 2. The 20, it was the 20 watt SVD that used the evolved chip. Nobody wants it because it's fucking stupid. It's that simple. Nobody wants old tech. It's a dead fucking tech. Nobody wants it. No, who's gonna spend, you know, $90 or whatever on a fucking tube mod that has a DNA 20 in it? Nobody wants that shit. And same with a DNA 30. Nobody wants a DNA 30 from Anokin. Now, I'll buy a DNA 30 from Vapor Flask because it's fucking awesome. But I'm not gonna buy a box mod with you know, from Anokin for $100. With a DNA 30, you know what I mean? I'm just not going to do that. I don't know about you, Tiger, but would you?
No. No. Oh, I see Paloma. Very clever. She had me all excited. Sam's telling me his mod charges his phone and does his hair. I'm like, I need that mod. Then Paloma steps it up. She tells me her mod does her makeup. And when I was just about to get excited, she says she prefers the natural look, and it does a great job of that. Well, I'm not that bright.
All right, Tiger. So on to you. What do you got?
I got, well, I guess you could say, I'm going to have a little fun with this one. I guess you can say I got zilch, or should I say zero. Another hot copy breaking this week, this Zero Mods. This is a G sensor, Zero Mod style, okay, please, this is a replica, this is not an original. G sensor APV. Coming in at $68 and change, this is a 35 watt, and it's beautiful. And, you know, my pictures aren't doing it justice. You got to get right in there and get close up with this baby to really appreciate what's going on here. Let me walk you through it. As you can see, there's your display, there's your firing button, your 510 connection up on top there, okay? Laying it down, you get a better view of how that all fits together. Now, your one edge is rounded, a little bit iStick-esque in its appearance, but of course a much beefier, you know, heftier mod. Now, when you slide off this cover, that covers all the way around, what you expose underneath is a wooden housing. Now, I don't know what brought them to do that in the first place, but I got to thinking about it, and, you know, like, I'm not that familiar with the original Zero. I've heard of it. I know people are really impressed with them. They're pretty impressed so far from what I'm hearing with the clones as well, but, you know, I'm not that familiar with what thought processes went into developing it, but I'm looking at that going, well, wood is lightweight. It's an awesome insulator. It's certainly not going to ever short anything out. This is all kinds of win. This is actually really brilliant. So, you know, and that's what you do. You slide that off. Your battery gets tucked in here between the connections. The cover goes back on and you're vaping. Kind of neat. Now, in terms of the chipset and how it all works, what's going on under the hood, I'm not completely up to speed on this yet. What I can tell you is this the SX chip again, Joe?
Yeah, it's a Yeehi chip.
It's a Yeehi. Okay. So, okay. Well, that changes that. Then we know what we're dealing with. That's the Yeehi SX350, I guess, then, right?
300.
Oh, 300. Ah.
It's a SX300. You know, I mean, it's a stable, good chip. For $68, I mean, look at what you get. I mean, it's a very efficient chip. I love the double, you know, the wood inside and then the outer metal shell. You know, they also, after you click this link over, they actually have a DNA, I think it's 30, DNA 40, you know, esque version of this. It looks exactly the same, except instead of the Yeehi chip, they're using the Qi DNA chip. But I like the Yeehi chips better, to be honest with you. I like the screen better.
Retroxify, I love it. I love it. Yeehi inside, the rehashing the old Intel thing. I love it. All right, where are we at? 11:12. Holy mackerel! How did these shows fly, Joe? So much. It's all right. I'm going to drop another link in the room. Now, we've talked an awful lot today, lately, the last few months, about box mods. Everything's box mods. Well, you know what? There are still those of you out there who prefer a cylinder, the tube style, you know, something that reminds you a little more of the mechanical, something that's, you know, that different form factor. Well, here's one for you. The Tesla 8.
It's the Tesla.
Yeah. Is Tony in the room with us? Tony? It's Tony's Tesla. This is the version 8. It is a variable wattage mod. And now I have completely forgot. Is this a 30? Yeah, this is the 30 watt. Okay. I talk about too many different wattage things and I got them all snarled up now. Now, you know, it's a pretty straightforward, no-nonsense, 30-watt, 18650 tube mod. What you're basically seeing is a much nicer, better built, and, you know, more powerful VAMO at really a fairly competitive price. $45 and beautifully made with, you know, up to 30 watts. That's not a bad buy. And this is going to... this is going to do everything one of your 30-watt box mods is going to do, but in the form factor you prefer. So I wanted to make sure you guys knew about that one. I think it's a great-looking mod. Like, I'm sorry. I mean, I'm a fan of the VAMO. They're workhorses. They're cheap. They work. But this is pretty hot-looking compared to a VAMO. And, of course, more power. Well, than most of them.
Yeah, I'm a fan of Tesla. I'm just not a fan of the tube mods anymore. I just think down with all tube mods. I just hate tube mods. I don't know what it is. I guess maybe, you know, when I was younger, I was beaten with a tube mod. I don't know what it was. I'm just not a fan of tube mods anymore. I'm just sick of them. But some people absolutely love them. They love the form factor, how the atomizer fits perfectly on the top. Everything's, you know, cylindrical and beautiful, and it just reminds them that nowadays box mods are where I'm at. But, you know, for the price and you know, the wattage, and it's a good name, the Tesla, you know, it's worth it if you like, you know, tube mods.
If you like Teslas,
you'll be happy with this.
It's a mighty fine Tesla. Alrighty. Well, Joe, you want to jump in here?
Yeah, I'm looking for, I'm trying to find a deal that I put up that has a sold out.
All right. Oh man, they're just selling like hotcakes. I guess everybody's doing their Christmas shopping.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just looking for something that hasn't really been crazy. Well, you know what? This mini me IAX style, I think I'm gonna use this one. There we go. Now this is an interesting model because this is a tiny hybrid. It's $16.61 from Fastech. If you look at it, you may think it's a big dripper. You may look at it and think this is a big boy dripper that you would put on a mod. This is actually the full mod. This is a mod and a dripper combined. And it's an 18350 hybrid dripper. Super cute, super tiny. A lot of people are talking about this for juice tasting. Now, Tiger, you were talking to me about the ceramic center post.
Well, I'm glad you asked because I did get a chance to talk to somebody who knows. Now, what I want to do before I launch into a tirade is see if I can... Oh, is that going to fit in the... No, I got to make a new one. Okay, give me just 2 seconds. I want to make a screen region that the people can actually see what's going on here. Add screen region, and they can see how cute this little tiny thing is. There it is. There it is. There it is. The Nano. And what's going on here? Oh, and you don't have a picture of Under the Hood, do you?
No.
Oh, okay. Well,
you're going to have to click my link.
No, what I want to do, Joe, just give me 2 seconds because I want to show them Under the Hood. It's critical to understand how this thing's built. I guess I can start here. I'm scrolled right off. Let me bring that up where you'll see it. These right here that accompany it, these funny little tubes that you're seeing here. It's like, what is that? Let me explain. What happens is under the hood, instead of having two terminals, the way you're used to seeing, there's a screw here and a screw there. There's a post in the middle. There's a post on the outside. However it's laid out. This one has a long, thin pin in the center, just a long, thin pin sticking up, and one screw on the deck. When I first looked at that, I'm like, how in the hang is that supposed to work? Let me explain. These are ceramic wicks, okay? They are a firm ceramic with a hole in the middle that drops over that center pin. Then you take your wire, whatever you're going to make your coil with, you slide it through one of these little coiled springs, and that whole assembly goes over the top down onto that ceramic wick, holding it in place as well, holding everything in place, and your tail end of the wire is coming up the top. Now your wire is pinned to that pin with the little spring, okay? Then you take your wire, you wrap it around your ceramic coil, and secure it to the negative post on the deck. It's kind of brilliant. And the deck is lightly bowl-shaped to drive the juice down to the ceramic wick. But that to me also means that you can have a little pool of juice in there. So you don't want to lay this thing down and it'll leak out the air hole, right?
Right.
I looked at that and I'm, you know, we're good friends, of course, with Lucidius Rage, RBA supplies, and I'm thinking, this is made for Ready X Wick. Now, I'm in Canada. I haven't had the privilege of using that. That does not ship outside the U.S., but for those of you in the U.S., this is made for that. So I had a powwow with Lucidius. I said, hey, you know your product better than I do. Look at this. I explained it. I said, what do you think? He said, absolutely. He says, I think it would work fabulous. Because, of course, the Ready X Wick is a hollow core. It'll slide right over that perfectly, too. And in my opinion, it's a superior product to the hard ceramic. Easier to clean up, easier to replace, cheaper to replace, probably even when it's time. I mean, the Ready X Wick's going to last forever. You might be sick of the mod by the time your first wick wears out. And what it'll also allow you to do is if you make that wick a little too long, what I'm suggesting, and you know, this is all theory, I haven't had a chance to try this, right? Fray the bottom and push it down a little farther than it would sit naturally. And now you've got bits of the wick out into that juice pool, kind of soaking it up, holding it there. It's less likely to run all over, and it's going to also drive that juice up the rest of the wick easier. So I think this has a lot of possibilities. I think it could end up being a great flavor addy, flavor setup really, because it's a hybrid, and all in this teeny tiny little adorable package of 18350. So there you go.
Yep.
So check it out. Head on over to RBA Supplies for your whip.
This is another really awesome stealth setup. I mean, you got to remember, this takes a little 18350 battery. It's got the atomizer built into it, so a hybrid system. You know, little fire bottom buttons. You know, it's just great. I think it's really cool for the price. $16 for a hybrid? Come on! Mm-hmm. They used to be $216. Now it's $16.
Yeah, absolutely.
So get over there and check it out. Okay, Tiger, what do you got?
Well, let's see here. I have sort of a K-Fun alternative, if you will. It is a K-Fun, but it's a special one. This is the limited edition. It's the Five Ponds edition replica, okay? So this is a K-Fun light, but it's got a totally different look to it. The K-Fun light, okay, it's an all right looking atomizer. I thought, you know, if you really like your K-Fun light vape, but you're kind of sick of the look, you want to change it up, you've got them on every device, you'd like something different. This is pretty handsome, okay? Of course, the pawn shaped drip tip.
The only true pawn, you know, they call other ones pawns. This is the only true pawn drip tip I've ever seen.
Yeah, this looks like a chess piece to me. The other ones, it's like, well, yeah, okay, I kind of get where you're going with that, but... and then the five pawns on the bottom. Now, you know, okay, that is very, very much branding. Now we're looking at, you know, is this a new special clone because it's a branded limited edition? It's like a clone twice over because they've kind of copied two things. I don't know where to go with this, but I'm here to show you, and there it is. 1247 for a K-Fun light style, and of course all the extra screws and O-rings that you'll need over time. But
I think it's cool, you know. I mean, I don't know, if I went on Fast Tech and I saw the Vapor Joe's fucking, you know, Addy, I would love it. I'd be like, that is awesome. You know, that would blow my mind if I went and I was like, oh, Vapor Joe's are around like the bottom of a cave hunter, that would be fucking great. It's like, you have arrived, bitch. You have arrived.
Alrighty. Well, do you have any more you want to share? I have one left, and we've got 7 minutes left to the bottom of the hour.
You go.
All right. Well, this one, it's not a really big deal, and I saved it to the end because it's not going to be a deal for everybody. This is a very, very specific, purpose-driven deal, if you will. But I thought they were so cool and so cute and so reasonable. How did you know, Big Bam? Seriously, on that one, how did you know? That's scary. Get out of my head. Wow. He's amazing. This is a 2-in-1 cap tip for Tobe style, the Tobe V2 style RDAs. So if you have a Tobe V2 and you're enamored with those, they're calling them there's chuff caps, they're wide bore, there's all kinds of names. I don't really know if this would. Let's just call it a real wide bore drip tip and leave it at that. But I thought they were pretty fun because I love the glass. I love that it's made of glass. I love vaping on a glass drip tip. They are so, they just are so clean flavored and easy to keep clean. And you never have to worry about your juices eating away at them. I mean, I remember back when I started vaping, certain juices and certain acrylic tips, and people were showing horror stories of what the juices were doing to these things. You just don't even think about that with glass, okay? And the rest of the assembly, the plastic part, the brightly colored, is your ABS, which is a very hard, heat resistant and hard wearing plastic. So I feel pretty confident about that. But they're just so fun. I love the bright colors. I wanted to share with you guys. So if you have a Tobe V2, there you go. Great big wide cloud blowing drip tip.
Dot com.
Oh, Son of Sam, Thunder Chicken. Well, where I come from, that's a mocking name for a Thunderbird, a car.
Oh. You would, well, yeah, because Canadians are so well known for their cars, they could make a Thunderbird if they tried up in Canada.
Huh?
Well, because you make fun of Thunderbirds, which is a car, right?
Uh-huh.
Which is an American car.
Well, it's not personal, Joe.
Oh.
Actually, the reason I know this is from Disney Pixar's Cars movie. Thank you very much. So, you know.
No, this is an American-made Cars until Canada comes out with a car that's like, oh, I need a Canadian car.
Well, it's not about Canadian. It's about the not very nice racer in Cars is called Chip. And that's because he's a Thunderbird. A Thunder Chicken.
Oh, okay.
So, there you go. Where's Disney Lynn's or Freeze when I need them? Somebody back me up here. All right, Joe. That's it. I'm out of deals.
I have one
I'm
more.
Done.
And this is something that's pretty much American only, but you're going to deal with it. We're talking 1 liter of 100 milligram Nick base for $50. Some of the finest Nick base you're going to get. This is from My Freedom Smokes. You're going to basically, you DIY, you could turn 1 liter, like my Nick level, into 540 30 mil bottles of juice. Now, this gives you a summit of how much money juice makers make. Because if we were to make 100, if you were to make 6 milligram Nick juice, and turn it into 540 30 mil bottles. Okay. Now, of course, you have to buy the flip, but I mean, the ring split. But just take a $50 investment.
When you get right down to it, flavoring is the most expensive part of your juice. The rest of the ingredients cost next to nothing. You're talking about pennies in that bottle. And then beyond the ingredients and what goes into your juice and the flavor being the most expensive, probably the next most expensive part of your juice is the pretty packaging it comes in. So every time you get one of those super fancy glass bottles with a super fancy label in shredded whatever in a box, in a tube with the ribbon and raffia. I'm not picking on anybody, but I'm just saying, you know, and if that's your thing, I have things like that too. I go to Starbucks. I like my fancy coffee. Is it really so much better than the coffee I can make here at home? No, it's part of the experience. I get that. You know, treat yourselves. Have your little luxuries. But, you know, there's an awful lot of really great juice being sold in plastic, plain, childproof dripper bottles. That's just as good as the stuff that you throw away, all the stuff you just paid for, because it's just packaging.
Right, so in the end, for those of you who want to make your own DIY 100 milligram Nick base, which will last, I mean, if you buy a liter of Nick base at 100 milligram, the average vapor, that will last you probably a lifetime for $50.
Now, D. Millen, I half agree with you. 100 milligram Nick is not for beginner DIY. I will say you can't, it's dangerous. It's a dangerous substance, and it must be treated and stored with respect. If you're using 100 milligram Nick, you're using gloves. You're using proper tools. Now, I'll confess, I don't do this myself, but I do recommend when I'm talking to new people, eye protection. Last thing you need is a tiny little splash of that with something hits, just you know, flying up and going in your eye. That's not a day you want to have, okay? You get 100 milligram Nick on your skin, you're going to know it very, very quickly, in like seconds. You're going to get that feeling of when you nicked out. If you haven't done it to yourself in vaping, you might remember from smoking. If you sat down, you were having one of those really, really stressful days and you're just chain smoking and you get the nick rush and you kind of have to lay down, right? You're going to start getting that hot flush. You want to, if you get any 100 milligram Nick on your skin, you wash immediately. No bones about it. And in terms of storage, I share my abode with a 4-year-old. The outcome of a four-year-old getting their hands on a bottle like this would be, we don't even want to think about it tonight. And as a matter of fact, you know, to share my personal life, my little boy has learned how to get over the counter into the kitchen now. And a couple times I've come and, you know, he's so quiet in the morning. And then all of a sudden you hear a noise in the kitchen. You go roaring in there. And yeah, he's got the fridge half unloaded onto the floor and he's checking out what's in there. Now I store my Nick in the fridge. That's the last thing you want him getting a hold of, right? I have a lockbox. It's a locked safe box where all of my stuff like this goes. And even if he unloads the whole fridge, gets to the back, gets the box out, I have the only key. So, you know, do store it responsibly. If you have small kids around, you want it in a locked place. If you have pets around, you want it inaccessible to them. And yes, Albie, anytime it's quiet, it's trouble. You got that right. I can hear through tons of noise, but as soon as it gets quiet, what's going on? But yeah, do be careful. Don't be afraid of nicotine, but you want to be respectful.
All right, so that was the last deal of the evening. The time is now 2:30. I think we can call it on time.
I think so. I think absolutely. I think our timing was just perfect tonight. Wow, we ran out of deals when we ran out of time. And
all right, so we'll see you next week, and here at VU Live, if anybody wants to come on and take over after us, you're more than welcome to start late after hours. But we'll see you next week here on Done Deal right after Monday.
You betcha. And Bath, did I do see your question? I'll address it just before we drop the cast. One for the first time tonight on Mod Envy, and you were on the phone. Bath, I can confirm you won. I remember reading your name. I do apologize. I'm sorry. I don't personally remember what prize it was associated with. And the only way I know of finding that out is watching the replay. Am I right, Joe?
That's
is there
it.
Another way? All right. So the replay will be posted tomorrow, typically, provided, you know, Smokey has time to get that done. But typically those are up on Sundays and you'll be able to find out there. Sorry, I don't have a better answer for you.
All right. So we'll talk to you guys next week. See you later.
All righty. Have a good night, everybody.